Hi, I'm Kelly.
And I'm Liz.
And we are both speech-language pathologists at Cleveland Hearing and Speech Center. I'm going to be showing you how to have a shared book reading experience with your child and increase their language skills. I'm going to be playing the parent, and Liz is going to be playing the child in this situation. So, first thing you can do to add a bunch of language is to just look at the cover. Talk about characters. Liz, do you know who's going to be the character in this story?
Bird?
Yeah, maybe. Maybe the bird, maybe this lady right here. Liz, what do you think might happen in this story?
I think she might do some laundry.
Yeah, so you can ask a lot of questions so the child can predict what's going to happen next in the story. Really increase those inferencing skills. Another language skill you can address is doing a lot of open-ended questions. Like, Liz, I wonder what she's hanging up.
It looks like a skirt.
Yeah, she's hanging up a green skirt.
I see underwear.
Yes, underwear. That is silly. It's on the string. Another skill that you can work on with your child is rhyming skills. This is a good skill for phonological awareness. So as you're reading, maybe after you're done reading, you pick two words out. Ask your child, did those words rhyme? For example, she hangs up the stockings, she hangs up the shoes, she rings out the paper and hangs up the news. Liz, I heard some rhyming words. Shoes and news. Do those words rhyme?
Shoes, news. Yes.
Yes. You can help your child with rhyming skills by telling them that rhyming words sound the same at the end of the word, like shoes and news. They both end in ooze. Another language skill we can use is extending and expanding upon your child's utterances to make the sentences longer and more descriptive. For example, Liz is going to point to something.
I see a dog.
Yeah, so she said, I see a dog. I'm going to extend and expand on that sentence and say, yes, I see a gray dog hanging on the string. So I added more description. I added some prepositions on the string. Now, another skill we can work on is inferencing or predicting what might happen next in this story. So Liz, she's hanging up this phone and there's this barrel here. What do you think she's going to do next?
Maybe she'll pop some bubbles.
Maybe. Let's see. She's hanging up more clothes.
And bats.
Those bats are upside down.